Hello friends, welcome to Devrat Knowledge Villa. You are watching our English video series of operating system and learning deadlock. Today's our topic is necessary conditions to occur the deadlock. Actually, we are discussing deadlock characterization. In terms of deadlock characterizations, there are three topics. First one is necessary condition to occur the deadlock. Second one is resource allocation graph. And third one is deadlock handling strategies. So out of these three, today we will discuss necessary conditions to occur the deadlock. So guys, there are total four necessary conditions are there to occur the deadlock. Those are mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, and circular wait. So let's start learning these all necessary conditions without wasting a time. Let's start. Here we are going to take first one non-technical example, then I will lead to you into the technical terms. Let's see, consider here, it is the example of smart city or a pre-planned city. Look like if you visited Gandhinagar in Gujarat, so it is a pre-planned city and you will look this type of streets and road into the Gandhinagar. So suppose consider in this directions cars or any vehicles are traveling into this directions. So these arrows, you have to imagine these arrows as a vehicles or a cars. Get it? Now suppose same thing in from the another street or another road, few cars are traveling in this directions. Get it? But here actually at this choke or this junctions, these vehicles are traveling into this direction. So remaining vehicles which are arriving from the another directions will not be able to pass this junction, so they have to wait at here. Same thing, this waiting lead up to the long distance. Same thing at these junctions, these vehicles are in waiting. Same thing at this junction, some vehicles are traveling from the another directions. So again, if this junction will lead a traffic jam, so again this road have to wait till the that traffic is going to be clear. Same thing, these vehicles holding these junctions and few vehicles are traveling from this direction. So again, here is a traffic jam, so they have to wait till the clear. Same thing, this vehicle have to stop here due to the traffic at this junction. So suddenly in this type of situations, every junction will lead the traffic. It means there is at every four junctions have a traffic jam. So all are in waiting now. So this type of situation is known as a deadlock. Let's see one by one. Suppose we are going to start from these junctions. These vehicles are traveling in this direction. Get it? So this junction is held by these vehicles and these vehicles are waiting. It means mutually they are using this junction. So that is our first thing, because this junction is in non-shareable mode. Get it? So first condition, that is mutual exclusion. It means mutually these vehicles are holding these junctions and these vehicles are not holding. If these vehicles will try to hold this junction, then it will lead to accident. Get it? So we can say that first condition, that is mutual exclusion. Mutually these vehicles are holding this junction. Second thing, let's see here, these vehicles are holding this junction. Suppose these vehicles are traveling in this direction. So this junction is held by these vehicles. But whenever these vehicles reach at this junction, so this junction is actually in traffic jam. So these vehicles are not holding this junction. Get it? These vehicles are holding this one junction only and waiting to hold second junction. It means at least whenever all vehicles will get both the junctions parallelly, so then and then that vehicle can go ahead, otherwise not. Get it? So to pass out in earlier way, remaining way, they have to cross both the junctions. But right now these vehicles have to cross this junction, but they are waiting to cross second one. It means these vehicles are holding first junctions and waiting for second one. So our second condition is hold and wait. Now let's discuss here, that is a third case. Suppose traffic police will arrive and traffic police will stop this vehicle at before reaching any vehicle to the junction, this junction is going to be free, otherwise not. Get it? Otherwise no one can stop this vehicle. So our third case is, that is no preemption. Our third case is no preemption. It means we can't stop any vehicle forcefully. Yeah, whenever traffic police will arrive and then they can stop the car. It means no preemption. Preempt means to stop anything. Get it? So third case is no preemption. So no one will able to preempt this junction, or no one will able to stop these vehicles here. So that's why we are not going to solve the traffic jam. Second thing, fourth case, that is due to the one by one happening, these cases actually all are in waiting state. Get it? First we have started from this direction. So this junction is held by these vehicles. Second, some vehicles arrived from again second directions. Some vehicles arrived from third direction and some vehicles arrive from fourth direction. So every junctions are occupied and suddenly entire vehicles or all vehicles will reach into the waiting state. Get it? So this thing is known as a circular wait. So hope you are understanding. Guys, if you have any query regarding to the understanding out of these four conditions, so please comment me in comment box. Let's start discuss everything technically one by one. Same thing we have discussed our earlier example of deadlock. What is deadlock? At that time we have discussed by taking two example of male and female. Those are ready to drink a soup, but due to the lack of resources they are not able to drink a soup. So it is our first lecture of what is deadlock. So if you are still remain to watch our first lecture of what is deadlock, so guys please click here in I button at top right corner and please watch the video of what is deadlock, so you will easily understand the all four necessary conditions to occur the deadlock. Same mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption and circular wait position we can discuss with or we can compare with these examples. Like mutually a person is using bowl and mutually this female person is using the spoon. Get it? So that is mutual exclusion. Second thing, hold and wait. It means person holding bowl and waiting for spoon. Same thing, this female person holding spoon and waiting for bowl, that is hold and wait. No preemption. They can't say each other forcefully, please release the spoon and I want to drink a soup. Get it? So they can't stop each other forcefully. Yeah, they can request only for remaining resources. Circular wait. Due to the hold and wait of one and one resources, this entire position will lead to the circular wait. Let's start technically with the first our condition, that is mutual exclusion. So let's understand mutual exclusion technically. What technical terms is there? That is, at least one resource must be held in non-shareable mode. Get it? It means if you consider this junction as a resource, so we can say that at least one resource must be held in non-shareable mode. This junction is in non-shareable mode because vehicles which are arriving from this direction, these vehicles are using this junction. Get it? Whereas vehicles arriving from this directions, that vehicles are not using this junction. It means these vehicles are only using this junction. So this junction is used by only these vehicles. So we can say that it is in non-shareable mode. Look like reading a file and writing a file. Yeah, we can share a file to read for the every persons, but we cannot share a file to write for everyone. Only one person can write into the file. Say here. So it is our first point. Next, that is only one process at a time can use the resources. It means only these vehicles are using these junctions. So we can say that one process at a time can use the resources. Second thing, if another process requests that resources, the requesting process must be delayed until the process had been released. Suppose another process request, like this process are requesting, get it? These vehicles are requesting to this junction. So what happens? These vehicles get delayed until the process has been released. It means whenever these vehicles release this junction, then and then these vehicles get the junction. So we can say that another process request that resources, the requesting process must be delayed until the process has been released. Get it? So it is our first necessary condition, that is mutual exclusion. Hope you are understanding very well. Let's see. Second condition, that is hold and wait. What actually happened into the hold and wait? Let's discuss with this statement. A process must be holding at least one resource and waiting to acquire additional resources. It means right now this junction is hold by this first junction is actually hold. This junction is hold by these vehicles and waiting to acquire additional resources. It means they are waiting to use second junction. These vehicles are waiting to use second junction that are currently being held by other processes. It means these vehicles are waiting to use second junction, but actually second junction is held by another vehicles. So it is our second necessary condition, that is hold and wait. Let's see third scenario. No preemption. What actually the preemption meaning is to stop anything, that means preemption. Get it? So statement is resources cannot be preempted. Yeah. Whenever these vehicles are passing from this junction, so we can't say any driver to take their cars in reverse direction. Get it? After they reach into the junction. Get it? Yeah, we can stop from this point, but we can't stop from this point. Get it? Otherwise, it will lead more traffic. So it is our statement, resource cannot be preempted. Then after that is a resource can be released only voluntarily by the process holding it. Yeah, if this driver will understand, look like I am generating a traffic and mutually they can back their vehicle and they allow to pass another vehicles, so then and then this thing is possible. Otherwise, another scenario, like after using these junctions by these vehicles, whenever all vehicles will pass, then and then these vehicles get a chance to access this junction. Get it? So suppose this all vehicles traveled in this direction and then they are getting a chance, like after that process had completed its task. It means if all vehicles pass on and then these vehicles get a path. So that is third condition, no preemption. Let's see last scenario, that is circular wait. Due to this type of cases, like we have started from this direction, first those vehicles are traveling in this direction, then after second some vehicles arrive from this directions, then from third direction some vehicles arrive, and this fourth direction some vehicles arrive. So one by one they are holding a junction, and one by one they are generating a traffic. So this situations, entire situation is going to be occurs. This thing is known as a circular wait. Let's understand. A set of processes P0, P1 up to PN. These are the set of processes. Waiting processes must exist such that, get it? Look like these are the set of processes P0, P1 up to PN. Get it? So what is the situation? P0 is waiting for a resource held by P1. It means P0 actually want to use some resources that is held by P1. Look like actually this vehicle want to access this junction, which is actually held by some another vehicle. So same thing, we can say that P0 is waiting for a resource held by P1. Same thing, P1 is waiting for a resource held by P2. Same thing up to the PN-1, and PN-1 is waiting resources held by PN, and PN is waiting for a resource held by P0. So same thing, all vehicles are waiting for each other. It means all processes are waiting resources, which resources are actually held by another processes. So this condition is known as a circular wait. Hope you are understanding very well necessary conditions to occur the deadlock. If you have still any doubt, any query, you can comment me in comment box. In next session, we will discuss resource allocation graph. Thank you very much for watching. Devrat Knowledge Villa. Thanks.